Good morning, St. Andrew's College. I'm Braeden Donnelly, and this is SAC Today Christmas Special. In collaboration with the St. Mildred's Prefects, your St. Andrew's College Prefects worked on a white ribbon campaign video to show their support for the global movement of men and boys working to end male violence against women.
On December 6, 1989, 14 women were murdered at L'École Polytechnique in Montreal because they were women. 29 years ago, in 1991, the Canadian Parliament declared December 6th as a national day of remembrance and action on violence against women.
Your prefects put together a video in memory of the victims of the Montreal massacre. Without a live ceremony, both SAC and SMLS replicated the annual memorial on video. The prefects ensured no names from this tragic event were left unspoken.
When we come together collectively and take the pledge, we proceed with the hope that light will always shine in the darkness.
As many of you know, SAC Today is the leading news source for the upper school. Recently, however, we've expanded, with our junior correspondent, Gerry, coming all the way from the middle school. Take it away, Gerry.
I'm Gerry Zhang from the middle school. With the upper school doing online classes until the winter break, we have the whole entire campus to ourselves. Let's take a look.
Here in the upper school. Hey boys, I'm the teacher right here. Oh my.
Mr. Gerry?
Mr. Gerry, yeah.
Yeah, I have a question.
Oh my.
Where did the rest of the upper school go?
It's all ours.
Oh my. I love these things.
Oh, that's so nice.
For SAC Today, I'm Gerry Zhang.
Looking for some good movies to watch over the holiday break? Here's Nolan Rush with his holiday movie, Watch List.
Due to the pandemic, people have been unable to go to the movies since April, so many film companies have released their movies on streaming sites like Netflix, Amazon Prime Video, and Disney Plus instead of the theater. Some people may not have had the time to see these movies or haven't even heard of them, so I thought I would give my top 3 movies and TV show watch list that you can catch up during the winter holiday. Let's start with TV. The Queen's Gambit is a Netflix show that was released on October 23rd, 2020. The show is about Beth Harmon, an orphan chess prodigy superbly played by Anya Taylor-Joy, and her struggle with drug abuse as she tries to become one of the best chess players in the world. One bonus of watching The Queen's Gambit is seeing the scenes at Ohio State that were actually filmed on the SAC campus. Ted Lasso is a feel-good comedy available on Apple TV+. It is about an American football coach who is hired to coach an AFC soccer club in the UK. Jason Sudeikis plays Lasso, who is a lovable fool as the audience watches him learn how to coach soccer. The Crown has met with great success in all 4 seasons of its run so far, with stories about the current royal family. The acting is outstanding, with such recent notables as Academy Award winner Olivia Colman and Harry Potter star Helena Bonham Carter. This is a surprisingly captivating series, especially with its recent focus on the story of Prince Charles and Princess Diana. If you haven't already, watch the first 3 seasons on Netflix before embarking on the 4th one. Now on to the films. Onward is a heartwarming, fun animated feature film available on Disney+. It is an enjoyable film for the whole family, starring Chris Pratt, Tom Holland, and Julia Louis-Dreyfus. It tells a story of 2 brothers trying to reconnect with their dead father one last time and properly say goodbye. Hamilton, an American musical, is the 11-time Tony Award-winning Broadway show brought to the big screen through Disney+. This is a must-see for musical and history enthusiasts alike. Written by Tony, Grammy, and Emmy-winning Lin-Manuel Miranda through rap and hip-hop, Hamilton tells the tragic story of Alexander Hamilton, the first Treasury Secretary of the United States, as he goes from poverty to founding father. The Trial of the Chicago 7 is a star-studded Netflix movie that tells the true story of 7 Vietnam War protesters on trial for inciting riots in Chicago. Actors like Eddie Redmayne, Sacha Baron Cohen, and Joseph Gordon-Levitt give brilliant and true-life performances. I hope you get a chance to check out these shows and films. Happy holidays! For SAC Today, I'm Nolan Rush.
Recently, students at St. Andrews participated in the annual tradition of Holiday Hero, where students donate to at-risk youth in York Region. Thanks to all advisories and students for donating and making the holiday season just a little bit better for those in need.
Now that the snow is starting to fall and the lights are coming out, it is an indicator to all of us that the holiday seasons are underway. However, in these tough times of 2020, the tradition of giving we have celebrated for so long has become much more important, especially the tradition of giving to the less fortunate.
Because of COVID-19, many businesses have shut down, leaving people unemployed and penniless. However, it is still extremely important for everyone to receive gifts and be happy this holiday season.
In the basement of Memorial Chapel, faculty volunteers Ms. Tackleberry and Mr. Cowell wrap presents for the Holiday Hero program. For over 15 years, St. Andrews has worked with the York Region Children's Aid Society to deliver gifts to underprivileged youth. This year, the school organized gifts for 109 youths aged 15 to 21 years old. Of course, there's always more we can do. For instance, my family also made donations at the local fire station that will be distributed to children in need this season. Thanks to everyone in the St. Andrews community and beyond for making the holidays a little brighter for those in need.
For SAC Today, I'm Niko Anathasopoulos.
Tis the season of giving, and Santa did exactly that. He visited a couple of your prefects rather unexpectedly. Roll the tape.
So we're here, almost at the first house. We're gonna go see Dasher first, aka Caden McHenry. Dasher, how are you doing?
Oh, look at this.
Merry Christmas.
Thank you very much.
There you go.
Wow. Thank you.
Yeah.
I'll have to put them on.
Looks great. Looks great, folks. Great to see Dasher. Let's go on to Dancer.
Merry Christmas.
All right, so Gordy. Oh, I love this song.
Yeah.
Oh, wow. Okay, hey. Just kidding. I don't
know. Rush, oh. Merry Christmas.
Merry Christmas. What are you doing here?
I'm here to give you a present.
Thanks.
Merry Christmas, Rush.
Merry Christmas. Hey, wait, I got something for you.
You got something for me?
Yeah.
Oh my gosh, Santa never gets gifts.
Perfect, right?
Thank you.
You're welcome.
Thank you, Rush. That's very kind.
I like the camera crew.
Yeah, I got my Christmas elves with me.
Paul, Merry Christmas.
And Ryan.
How's it going?
Good. I'm still wearing my pajamas. Could you hold this? What is this?
Of course, these are shortbread cookies that my mom made.
How kind
yeah.
of your mom.
Santa's mom made. Santa's mom's still kicking around.
Nice.
Yep. Oh, no.
You didn't want to come say hi?
Are you scared of the rain? Come on, you can't be a Christmas elf if you're scared of the rain.
I like snow better than the rain.
I'm getting a call.
I think I hear it in the car, too.
Hey, Santa Dad. Santa Dad just concerned that we're using the sleigh carefully. Merry Christmas.
Thank you so much.
It's great to see you. I hope you're doing well.
Hope you're doing well too. So,
you're going to see your grandma reindeer.
Yes, soon. Yes, I am.
Right. That's awesome. Well, Merry Christmas to her and Merry Christmas to you. Donner!
What is up?
How's it going?
Dons? How are you doing?
Very much.
Thank you, Donner.
Donnelly, you're an absolute saint. Thank you so much.
Of course, I'm Saint Nick. Eddie! Come down, we want to see you, man. Eddie, Merry Christmas. How are you doing?
Good,
thanks.
Good? How are you?
We just came to give you a little Christmas gift. And we hope you're doing well. Happy holidays. Okay, see you, Eddie. All right, finished up all the reindeer, all the prefects. It was good to see everybody. My helping elves, they worked hard today. My camera crew, my moral support.
So one of my reindeer even came to see Santa Claus. Here's Alex Venton. You're Rudolph, actually.
Thank you. Awesome.
Everybody else got one.
Thank you. Thank you very much.
Santa couldn't cross the border this year, so we had to FaceTime David Kurp from all the way in Houston, Texas.
For SAC Today, I'm Santa Claus.
Due to COVID-19, Christmas will look a little different this year. To get a better understanding of what the boys are getting up to, junior correspondent Fynn has the story.
It's Ty here. So for the Christmas break, not too much is going to change for me. Going to play some football video games, but for the most part, you'll find me with my family on the couch Saturday and Sunday watching the NCAA and the NFL. So not much has changed from usual, but should be fun to go and play in the snow. Merry Christmas, everyone.
This holiday, I'll be spending time with my family, baking a lot, and watching lots of Christmas movies.
It must be a South Pole elf. You get the hell out of here.
Where do you want me to go?
I don't care where you go. I don't care that you're an elf. I don't care that you're nuts. I don't care that you're my son. Get out of my life. Now!
For the holidays this year, I got to fly back home to Houston, Texas, and spend some time with my family.
This Christmas, I'm going to be spending lots of time at my home in Aurora with my family.
I am very, very excited for this Christmas break. First of all, don't tell my dad, we're getting a hot tub this year, and we are so excited to spend every single day up at our local ski hill, having a blast, doing all our favorite ski runs, and then returning for a nice dip in the hot tub. I'm so excited, and I'm sure everyone else in my family is as well.
Up next is Ty and Lochlan with another episode of The Sports Desk.
We can't get our Christmas bonuses this year.
What? Are you kidding me? I'm taking this. And I'm leaving back to Richmond Hill. This wedding is...
This is The Sports Desk.
Ho, ho, ho. Merry Christmas and happy holidays. I'm Ty White, along here with my co-host Lochlan McTeague. And welcome to this festive episode of The Sports Desk, the show where we talk about sports.
That's right, Ty. First off, we got the NHL, where they have a preliminary start date of January the 13th, with plans for training camps to open in the first couple days of January. New division structures will also be in place for this season, and it will feature an all-Canadian division. That's right, folks. Get those igloos warmed up and that maple syrup ready, because it's time for some good old-fashioned Canadian division hockey!
On top of hockey, another Big Four sport that's returning soon is basketball with the NBA. The 2020-2021 NBA season is set to begin on Tuesday, December 22nd. As far as the Raptors go, our boys are heading down south to play their basketball in Tampa Bay, Florida, due to COVID reasons. I know most of you at home are getting needy around the holiday season, and so are pro athletes and sports teams. That's why we're heading to our first installment of Locke's List.
Today, we're going to be going over a list of what pro athletes and teams want this holiday season. The LA Chargers want a new coach. It's a shocker. Carson Wentz wants a time machine. Jamal Adams wants to break up a pass. Bradley Beal wants Russell Westbrook to pass the ball. The Leafs want to make it past the first round. The Jets want Trevor Lawrence. Nate Robinson, getting a little greedy this holiday season. He wants a pillow and some dignity. And finally, the MLB, well, simple. They just want to stay relevant. Thanks for tuning into Locke's List, everyone.
Sorry to interrupt this episode of the Sports Desk, but since we didn't do it last week, we got to recognize our first football boys. Congratulations to Mason Watson and Kieran Walters for signing to Laurier and Bishop's College. Way to go, boys. So we're getting towards the end of our episode today, and I wanted to do this right here, right now, for all the people at home. Lachlan, your friendship means so much to me, and you being my co-host and all, I had to go get you something real nice as a Christmas gift. It's a game-worn Julio Jones Falcons jersey.
Oh, you know I'm a Falcons fan too. I appreciate you, man. I appreciate that.
Merry Christmas, buddy.
Got you a 2014 Dion Phaneuf jersey. No! Size small.
You really shouldn't have.
And you know what? It is also signed.
No, you really shouldn't have, Lachlan. I'll be honest with you. This is a real piece of
Today's fun fact is all about former St. Andrews student Alex Newhook, who's been selected to be part of Team Canada's World Junior Hockey Championship roster. Newhook joins an absolutely stacked squad featuring 20, that's right, 20 first round NHL draft picks. All World Junior games can be found on the Sports Desk Network. I'm just kidding. We don't have a network. Well, that just about wraps up our content for this episode.
Wait!
Cupid, Donner, I got presents for you.
Santa!
Oh, wow!
Whoa!
Whoa!
I did not expect this!
Yeah. Oh my gosh.
Merry Christmas, you guys.
Santa, we got you a present too.
You did? Oh, man.
So I know, you know, we gotta keep things clean around the house, so I got you a bottle of sanitizing wipes.
Thanks.
Super cool, right?
Yeah.
Keep you clean!
Yes!
Thanks.
Wait, but Santa, I got you, wait, where's the other glove? Well, it's filled with chocolate. Oh.
Ah, thanks, Cupid.
Merry Christmas.
Ty, you're supposed to give me real gifts.
I didn't have one. I woke up late. I stole that too. I ate most of the chocolate. Go.
Get out of the shot.
Merry Christmas, everybody.
Get out of the shot.
Get out of the shot, Braeden.
Well, I'm Ty.
I'm Lachlan.
And this has been The Sports Desk. Merry Christmas. Tomorrow morning, 10 a.m., Santa's coming to town.
Santa! Oh my God! I know him!
How have students been spending their times in recent weeks? Here's Ben Goring with the story.
With the upper school moving into SAC Flex, many extracurriculars, including sports, have been pushed into the new year. With that in mind, I spoke to some of our students at the school to find out what they've been doing with their newfound free time.
So I've been staying at the Bedard House, Master's Row, with a couple of other boys, and we've been doing a lot of stuff together, like table tennis and playing card games, going for walks outside, which are obviously socially distanced, but having this social aspect to quarantine has really like helped me specifically because it's just not being cooped in a room all day.
So I started cooking some new things. I just made pizza subs like half an hour ago and they were awesome. So if you've never had a pizza sub before, it's like a sub bun. So like a bigger hot, like a mini baguette, right? And then you slice it and you put pizza sauce on it and cheese and like pepperoni, and then you bake it in the oven. And so it's like pizza on a bun, and then you eat it like a sandwich.
Well, I wouldn't even necessarily say that I've had that much free time. These teachers have been keeping us to the grindstone and leading up to Christmas break, which I completely understand, as we gotta get all of our units done, because I'd much rather not work over the break.
I've been stuck in quarantine, but we have a big hill on our property, so I've been ripping the sled in the backyard. Gnarly.
As we can tell, many of our students are doing some rather unique activities with their free time. Have a wonderful Christmas break. For SAC Today, I'm Ben Goring.
As we conclude this Christmas special, we'd like to take a moment of your time to thank some important members of our community. This year has been undoubtedly challenging, and all our faculty and staff have remained supportive and committed throughout. Each and every one of you have worked hard to ensure that our year goes as smoothly as possible, whether it be our health center team, our dining hall staff, our upper school leadership team, those who work in reception, all those who work in the residences, our custodial staff, and our very own teachers. For all of us at SAC Today, we say thank you and happy holidays.